All right. This is going to be one of our, podcast recordings. We're going to see how it works out. Dino Martinez is going to tell me a story, and then I'll ask him questions afterwards. Hello, this is Dino. We're actually out here at night at a supposedly haunted volcano in Malheur County. We're just sitting out here telling spooky stories. But the one I'm going to tell is what happened on one of our first ghost investigations. And this happened in a town called Weiser, Idaho. And it's going to be a long story, so bear with me. Now, my friend Victor, the one who's recording, was called out to this place by the owner because they were experiencing like poltergeist activity. And what I mean by that is apparently they have two at that time. How long ago was it? About 6 years ago?
About 6 years. Can I tell you a little story before you start your story?
Ahead.
So basically, this is what the lady told me.
Okay.
The whole time they lived there, she always felt that there was somebody always watching her. And, you know, creeped her out. And then finally, they bought another house. But they kept that house, and they would have their dad stay there, like when he came to visit. And her dad would even say that he would feel that somebody else was in the house with him. So that's when she called me and asked if we would do it. Okay, so go ahead.
Now, what I remember is when we interviewed the couple, the mom and dad, is at that time, the two girls, they were probably 14. And they told me a story, too, which was kind of creepy. But anyway, the girls lived upstairs. It was a two-story house. And the mom and dad had the master bedroom downstairs. And they had a Tickle Me Elmo. And this is what creeped out the father really bad. And I think this is probably the biggest reason why they called us. Now, this Tickle Me Elmo, I don't know if you're familiar with it. I had to look it up. But anyway, it's a kid's toy. And you would squeeze it, and it would giggle. And it would say certain phrases that were programmed into the doll. And it was one of the girls, and they kept it upstairs. Now, one of the daughters told me that she didn't want to live in the house anymore because the upstairs, especially her bedroom, if I remember correctly, I think they shared a bedroom, and the bathroom upstairs creeped them out. It creeped her out, that she would see the cupboards opening, she would hear footsteps in the hallway going downstairs, and there was something in her room. And I go, I asked her if she saw that doll. She said no. And this is when the father interrupted and said, well, one day, it was probably a little after 3 a.m, that the doll woke up the household giggling. And then it started giggling, and then it started saying things that weren't programmed into that doll.
That'd be creepy.
And exactly. And the dad, apparently, the father, got really creeped out. And he said the next day, he took the doll and threw it in the trash. And didn't think anything else of it. The following day, the day after he threw out the doll, they were in bed, asleep. And he says it had to have been about the same time you heard that doll woke him up by giggling and talking. And he goes, how did that get back into the house? And I go, did the kids see you throw it away and bring it back in? He said, no, because the kids were afraid of it. And I told him I was going to throw it away.
Shit.
And you don't remember that?
I don't remember that part. No.
And he goes, that's why, one of the reasons why we wanted to move and the reason why we called you guys out here. So we did an investigation and we were there. We probably got there at about 9. It was a summer, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was hot.
We got there at about 9 and we usually, when it's warm like that, we do it at night because of the creepiness effect. And we always think that there's more energy with spirits and whatnot at that time. And if it's demonic, of course, you're going to come out between 12 and 3 or a little after 3. So we were doing our investigation and really nothing out of the ordinary happened. I didn't feel uneasy. We took pictures and I don't remember if we really caught anything.
We did catch one thing.
Was it that shadow in the bathroom?
No, it was a shadow in one of the bedrooms.
It looked like
a guy in a black pea coat.
And
a sailor.
Luminum. Yeah. Yep, that's true. I didn't really catch anything out of the ordinary. We were sitting at the kitchen table Well, what we did really is one of us would stay inside while the other went outside. And that's to see, since we weren't getting any activity, we wanted to see if maybe it would be more active if there was just one of us in there. Maybe it was feeling threatened or whatever. So at one point, Victor stayed in by himself, and I think we took turns doing like 20 to 30 minutes inside investigating the house. And when it was my turn, I really didn't feel anything. I didn't see anything. I didn't hear anything. And I'm kind of the one that's kind of aggressive. I tell the spirits, I'm here. Touch me. Do what you want to. Let me know that you're here. But didn't feel anything. So we were winding down our investigation. It was probably about 4:30. We were sitting at the kitchen table.
Yep.
I think we were looking through our pictures and kind of analyzing, like running through the video recordings. Didn't pick up anything other than that one picture. Didn't pick up anything in the recordings. But out of the blue, when we were sitting there, I look around the room and everything's turning yellow. And I feel kind of dizzy. And then all of a sudden, after that yellow hue surrounds the room. I don't know if it was surrounding me or the room. I hear music, like from the early 1900s, like 1920, like what you hear in the cruise ships back then, or in the bars that they would play their weird music or carny music.
I remember you asking me, do you hear that?
Yeah, and I asked Victor, don't you hear that music? I'm finally on to something. You hear that music? And Victor couldn't hear it. Mm-mm. And to me, it was like I saw a big old flash over there. And to me, I don't know, it might have been a reflection on my glasses. To me, what was I going to say? Oh, it sounded, the music was so loud, it was like I was listening to the radio right next to me. And it was like, just really weird Oregon, Victorian style music. And Victor did not pick it up at all.
Nope.
So the next day, normally, we're fine the next day. We'll go home.
Well, let me tell you something just before you do that. You picked that up, or you heard that. I remember looking down the hallway, and I would tell you looked like somebody's peeking their head.
And I never saw.
Yeah.
So I guess at that point, I probably knew we were leaving, so it was like taunting us.
Yeah.
Like it was taunting me separately and then Victor separately. Because it knew we were leaving. Because it heard us. It heard, okay, it's almost time to go. Let's do what we need to do. But anyway, the next day, normally I'll sleep for a few hours. I'll wake up by 11 or 12. And then I'll start analyzing what we did. I'll listen to the recordings throughout the day. I'll look at the pictures. And I'll write down notes. But that day, I was totally out of it. I slept all of that, I think it was Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
We did it on Saturday,
yep.
I remember. I slept all that day Sunday into midday Monday. I slept over, I want to say about 30 hours maybe.
Wow.
I was totally out of it. And I told Victor that. Remember, I said, man, mm-hmm. I'm totally out of it. I slept all day. So that night, I want to say that was probably Tuesday. That evening, I'm in my room and I start throwing the USB in the computer so I can download pictures and the audio. And I was turned around towards the computer, and I have a TV, and it's behind me, so I'm actually facing away from the TV. My back's towards it. And back then, I had DirecTV, so I had a cable box. And I would never turn off the cable box. I would just turn off the TV. So when I turned it back on, it was always on the same station. So I was going through, turning on my computer and going through the thumb drive or whatever, the USB drive, then all of a sudden I hear ding or a ping. You know how TVs sound when they turn on?
Mm-hmm.
And those older TVs are loud. And then the room lit up. And I go, the TV just turned on. I turned around expecting to see whatever channel it was on. It was nothing but static. So it was not even on the channel it should have been on. The TV turned on to nothing but static and a humming. That
like the humming was coming from the TV
The TV, and it goes, that the tube or what? Oh, it couldn't have been a tube because I had one of those flat screens.
Yeah,
and it was humming, so I don't know if it was from the static. And well, that's really weird. Then the next day I had to work, and I come home from lunch, or for lunch. I go into the room, and in my room I have a wooden cross that they gave to me when my father passed away during his burial, and it has a brass Jesus Christ on it. And I have that over my bedroom door. As soon as you walk in, it's right over my door. I gotta explain this to you because this is really weird. Anyway, the little latch that where you hook a nail through to prop it on the wall. Well, that little triangle latch was, I kid you not, almost as big as a nail head. So I had to maneuver the nail head around that to get it through. And that thing was not moving. The cross would not, I'd slam the door and the cross would not move at all. So I got home and I look on the floor. The cross is on the floor. And the arm's broken.
The arm of Jesus is broken?
Is broken. Not the wooden part, just the arm of the brass part. How's that going to be?
Yeah.
No, not the wooden cross, but the arm of Jesus. You go, holy crap. And I couldn't find the piece, the little piece of the arm that broke.
Oh, really?
I couldn't find it. And I go, God, that's weird. So I did an experiment, and I hung the cross back up because the nail was still there. It's like somebody took it off and threw it down. Because the nail is still up there. And I go, it would take some time to take this cross off. So I hung the cross back on, up, and I started banging on the wall where the cross was hung up, or that little area above the door, mm-hmm. and the cross wouldn't move. And I was hitting it hard. I go, holy crap. And that happened 2 days after we investigated that house. And that's my first story. There's many more.
Well, let me ask you, when we first got to the house in Weiser, and you saw it, what did you think?
I didn't think anything.
Really? No feelings, no nothing like that?
Nothing like that. I looked at the house, and I go, oh, well, you know, it's a nice house, blah, blah, blah. You can tell it's an older house. But my first impression was, God, I hope they're not lying to us. Right. That's what I thought. Like the guy and the girl, they didn't look like shysters. You know, and the daughters looked real, like they got good grades in school. Like, they're not going to lie about anything. You know, but when I first got there, the house, it didn't bug me. Normally, I get a weird feeling. I think Victor does, too. But I didn't get any feeling at all. And then when they started telling us the story, I was like, is this real? Is this true? And then when we started investigating, normally I can pick up something. If there's true possession or entities or poltergeist activity or spiritual activity, I can pick it up. I can pick it up right away. And that day, up until the end, I did not feel anything, did not hear anything, did not feel anything.
I would say the moment I started feeling something is like around 4 o'clock in the morning when you heard the music, and I was seeing somebody peeking their
head.
That's
what I'm saying.
That's the only time I really felt anything.
They were hiding until we were getting ready mm-hmm. to leave, and then they showed themselves.
Yep, and the picture of that guy, we didn't see it because back then we had those cameras where you really couldn't see it.
Yeah,
little screens, so you really couldn't see it.
Yeah, and really low pixelation.
Yep. But I do remember taking a picture of the house from the outside, and there was like a mist. Oh. Around that, and I remember taking a couple, and both of them had the mist on it.
Because I took, that's probably when I was doing the investigation by myself inside.
Yep.
Because I did the same thing, and didn't see anything.
Yeah, but that was our first one, huh?
That was one of our very first